Dani Gasparini, and welcome to this segment of Penn Voice. I am joined today by Wendy Mattis, who is the founder and executive director of Jasper Ridge Farm. Wendy, thank you for joining us. Jasper Ridge Farm has been sort of one of my favorite nonprofits to watch because of what you do. So tell our viewers a little bit about your farm.
Well, we were founded in 2009 with the goal of sharing our gentle animals with children in need. So we started off transporting small animals to facilities like Ronald McDonald House and some of the local homeless shelters for families.
And so did these pets sort of start out as your...
No.
As your pets or ones that you went around the community and,
yes,
and so gathered together?
Yes, our first animal was a miniature horse who was donated to our program. And subsequent animals have all been adopted by Peninsula Humane Society.
So how did you even think of an idea or know that this was a connection you needed to make to bring these small animals to people of need?
Well, the inspiration was, personally, I have loved animals. I saw the movie National Velvet at the age of 5 and have loved horses ever since.
Right.
And my degree is in animal science, but I spent 20 years in high technology. In 98, I was diagnosed with MS, at which point I felt that I needed a lifestyle change. Mm-hmm. So I went out to the Webb Ranch in Portola Valley, mm-hmm. and they hired me as a riding instructor. In my first summer camp, I had a little girl who was 8 years old, typical horse-crazy little girl, and I taught her for 4 years. When she was 12, she was diagnosed with a brain tumor. Mm-hmm. And I took a miniature horse into her home to visit her, and it was that visit that inspired the founding of the organization.
You just knew how much it changed her life in that yes. moment's time.
Yes.
So now, today...
Today.
Jasper Ridge Farm is located
yes.
on Stanford property.
Yes.
And it looks a lot different because you have a lot of animals and
yes.
you do a lot of programming. So just give us a little flavor of some of your favorites.
Well, since that humble beginning, mm-hmm. we were offered by Webb Ranch a lovely 3-acre site on Stanford University land. And we raised the funds and built a new barn. Our programs had grown beyond our wildest imagination, and we just needed more room. So we now offer a horseback riding program for veterans. We offer Horse Buddies, which is our special needs experiential learning program mm-hmm. for children coming from San Mateo County Office of Education.
Mm-hmm.
We take animals to Elmwood Correctional Facility, and we have senior citizens who come to visit the animals at the farm. So we do a little bit of everything. We serve last year 2,033 children and adults in need in our community.
So can you kind of try and give us a picture, a verbal picture of when you see a veteran that mm. probably has been diagnosed with PTSD, the post-traumatic stress syndrome, and now they're either riding a horse or interacting with the horse. I mean, I know they fundamentally change
yes.
once dealing with animals.
Yes, it's the amazing gift that horses and really all animals give us. For the veterans I see, gradually they learn to trust mm. again. They develop this relationship with the horse who responds to them.
Right. Doesn't care about the background, doesn't care about
yes.
who they are today.
Yes, it's in the moment.
Right, it's in the moment. And also, too, with your children of special needs, so
yes.
children of developmental disabilities, so physical or even
yes.
mental, I can imagine that is a world that opens up that is so brand new for these children to be able to
yes.
Be riding the horse or tending to the horses and some of the other animals.
It's amazing. We feel and we see the benefits both emotionally, physically, cognitively, socially.
Right.
These children come, they may have never been close to a horse, but somehow they overcome their fear. They develop a relationship with a special horse. Their self-esteem improves, their balance improves. We like to do it as a group, and so it's kind of a team building experience. We find they motivate and encourage and support each other.
So I imagine it takes quite a bit of a village to run Jasper Ridge.
An army, yes.
Yeah, so how do you, in fact, do it?
We have an amazing, really an army of volunteers. I think we have 113 active volunteers. Some of them come and just take care of the animals. They clean their water buckets, feed them, clean the stalls. We have many volunteers that come and join us with the programs, both on site and also at the facilities we visit. So it takes many people.
Right. And you probably take a lot of program volunteers who actually deliver some of the programs that you offer at Jasper Ridge as well.
Yes.
And I do know, because I'm familiar with your organization, that you're always in need of raising funds to support the operations and the farm itself and the programs that you do offer. While you live on a very shoestring budget for what your true expenses are, you do need to raise funds for feed and for all sorts of things.
We do, and we don't charge for our programs. Right. We offer all programs free of charge to those in need. And so we rely on donations and grants to operate.
So if someone was interested in either volunteering or donating or finding more out, obviously they're going to head to your website. But can people just kind of show up to the ranch and visit and say hello, or do you need appointments? How does one
encourage appointments. We may have programs running and would not be able to spend time if someone just dropped in.
Right.
But we welcome visitors if they call ahead, spend time at the farm, meet some of the animals and some of the other amazing volunteers.
So how do you spread the word to tell people that this is available and is a service?
Generally word of mouth.
Okay. So hopefully this program will drive tons of folks over to Jasper
Ridge. We hope so, yes.
But sorry about that. So we have just about a minute left in the program. What's the kind of last thought that you want to make sure that all of our viewers learn about Jasper Ridge Farm?
Well, I think that we can learn a lot from the animals. Mm-hmm. And I think the great gift that the animals, whether the horses, the goats, the cat, or the rabbits, offer to our clients is this unconditional acceptance. And we find as volunteers and staff, we can learn a lot from the animals.
And I imagine that with all physical rehabilitation, this mental gift that's been given, this connection, is so important to one's recovery, one's well-being. And it's just that special bond that animals provide to humans. And I don't even know if we even know the magical part of all of it.
It's magic. You're right.
Right. Yeah. Well, I encourage all of our viewers to give you a buzz and check you out on the website. Donate, give, and volunteer.
Yes.
And we really would love to have you come back and tell us more about the programs and maybe bring one of your students or one of your participants and get their perspective as well.
I'd love to.
Well, thanks, Wendy, for joining us on Penn Voice.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. And we'll see all of you next time on Penn Voice.